Do you want a carrot? Do you like it? There you go, very nice. Hello everybody and welcome back to another video on the Relax My Dog YouTube channel. Today, even though I've got my adorable little puppy here, we're going to be talking about something that's much less adorable. Fleas. So fleas are obviously really nasty and they can make your dog really itchy and uncomfortable, but more than that, they can actually be really dangerous to your dog. Fleas can carry all sorts of really dangerous parasites and diseases that they can transmit to your dog, and especially if your dog's weaker or younger, it can be really, really dangerous for them. So obviously we want to get rid of these, and today we're going to talk a little bit about how to do that. The first thing to do is check your dog for fleas. It's very similar to checking for head lice on humans. You just kind of have a look in the fur, part the fur, have a look around, see if you can see any little black dots moving around, and that's probably a sign that your dog has fleas. And that could definitely be the case if your dog has bald spots or dry skin as well. And if you find any kind of clusters of little red bites on you as well, that could be a sign that there's fleas somewhere in your house. Finally, if your dog's just acting a little bit unwell and not quite himself, that could be a sign that he's been transmitted something off fleas. So how do you get rid of fleas once your dog's got them? There's actually loads of different ways you can get rid of fleas. There's loads of collars, pills, shampoos, powders that you can use, and it can be really overwhelming when you see just how much choice there is. What I'd say is just to consider what kind of things your dog's comfortable with and then go from there. For example, Taff absolutely hates water. He hates having a bath, so I probably wouldn't choose a shampoo for him.
Stop it! Oh my god, Taff. It's not that bad, sweetheart. It's not. It's nice and warm. Oh god.
Let me know in the comments how your dog feels about water and baths, because I've met loads of dogs that really love it, but Taff won't even go in puddles or anything. He absolutely hates water. Also, make sure to have a really good look at the reviews of a product before you buy it, especially if it's a kind of herbal remedy, because some of these can actually be toxic to dogs. If the problem's really severe, definitely consider taking your dog to a vet, because they can administer stronger drugs and injections to your dog that can be a bit more of a long-lasting solution. So once you've got rid of the fleas, how do you keep them away? The most important thing to do to make sure you keep the fleas away is to really deep clean your house, especially any soft furnishings like sofas and bedding that your dog's been on. Fleas can live on this without a host for ages and ages, so it's really important to do a good vacuum and a good wash of all stuff that your dog's been near. Even stuff that your dog hasn't been near, it's a good idea to clean that just in case. Also, if you have any other pets, especially things like cats and rabbits, you want to make sure you give them a flea treatment as well, because the fleas could also start living on them. They're really not fussy about who they live on. Fleas can also live on your pet dormant for months on end, so it's really important to keep up with a regular flea treatment if your dog's had fleas, to make sure that you keep treating it so that they don't come back. So thank you everybody for watching the video. We hope your doggies don't have fleas, but if they do, hopefully this video gave you some good tips and tricks that you can use to get rid of them and deal with them. Remember to like and comment on this video and subscribe to the Relax My Dog channel. Also, check out some of our other videos for more great advice about dogs. See you next time.